Hi. Here we go. We have changed places after halftime. I have three lovely ladies with me. The gentlemen are in the back. Dorothy, Joe, and Bob are in the lead with $225. You got to play catch up. Listen to this one, fellas. You're helping out a worthwhile charity bazaar by selling kisses in their kissing booth for $100 apiece. That's very nice of you. In the middle of the evening, a man you've never seen before steps up and offers you $1,000 for a kiss. Would you sell him a kiss for $1,000? Yes or no? Okay, there you are in the charity booth. The offer is $1,000. Think it over, fellas. Goodbye. I can see their faces and you can't. Joni, we're going to start with Richard. What do you think he'll do?
Simple, because he kisses men anyway. You know that? No, he does. He's a very, very warm person, and he does kiss his male friends. So I know for sure that he would say yes for $1,000 for charity. He's a good sport. He's willing to earn some money for a worthwhile cause. So definitely yes.
The answer is definitely yes. I was just waiting to see what else would happen. Okay, it's a definite yes. He'll kiss the man for $1,000.
Sure.
Would he take 5.5? Here he comes now. Richard, this fella steps up in the middle of all of this kissing and offers you $1,000 instead of the normal price, right? $1,000. Would you sell him a kiss for $1,000?
Give me a kiss and I'll tell you, bro. Hey. Well, sure, if it was a charity, I'd be there for the reason of raising money. And I would kiss 9 guys for $1,000.
All right, you got it.
But for you, $1.95.
I think we've got 9 guys in a red section. I'll take you up on that,
my
too, Richard.
Pleasure.
Thank you. Dorothy, Joe, what will Bob say?
Well, not too long ago, there was a Frenchman on Price is Right, and he gave him a big kiss.
Really?
After he won a car or something, and it didn't seem to bother Barker a lot, so I'm sure he just assumed whoever the other fellow was.
Right, okay. I think that's only fair, as long as he doesn't come around again, right?
Just once.
Okay, the answer was yes. Here comes Bob. Bob, this fellow steps up in the middle of the evening, offers you $1,000 for a kiss. Would you sell him a kiss for $1,000?
I hate this question.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do the right thing for my charity. On the other hand, yes, a little peck on the cheek.
You got it. A little peck on the cheek. I don't know, it'd be a very expensive peck on the cheek, wouldn't it? I mean, if I was going to pay you $1,000, I'd want to kiss you, you know, all the way there, Bob.
Well, now, for you, Bird, anything, you know.
I had a fellow... What would Jack say?
Yes, he would.
He would
very, very deep into charities, and he would.
He'd
and just like Jody's, Jack does kiss some of his friends. I mean, it's just a thing to do.
Sure.
It's very European, and
right.
Jack would. For $1,000,
why not? Here he comes. The answer is yes. Jack, there you are.
Yes, sir.
This is for this worthwhile charity in the bazaar, and man comes up to you, offers you $1,000 if you give him a kiss. Would you sell him a kiss for $1,000?
Now, I believe you said it's someone I had never seen before.
That's right. Strange man.
Strange. Yeah, he would be strange.
Is that what it says in the middle of me? A man you've never seen before steps up and offers you $1,000. Correct.
Man I'd never seen before. I'd have to say no.
No, that's not what those say.
Oh, Jeff!
What interests me is that if it's a guy you knew, you'd kiss him. Jack?
Well,
oh, I remember you. Give me a kiss.
I'm sorry I said that now.
Sorry about that. Yeah, the bananas are kind of sorry, too. Sorry, Jack. You got a big question coming up, though. Dorothy, Joe, and Bob, and Jody, and Richard, split that one in half, and we'll come back in a moment with a $300 question. What would you do? Would you kiss a strange man?
Well, of course, my dear.
Stay tuned. Game show Saturday night's coming right back.
Here we go. This question worth $300. This will decide it. Gentlemen, it's for you. Which of the two of you is more adaptable to change? You or your gal? Good question, too. Which of the two of you is more adaptable to change? Off you go. And we'll start with Doe. Between you and Jack, which of you is more adaptable?
I.
It's definitely you. Here comes Jack. Jack, which of the two of you is more adaptable to change, you or Doe?
Well, we're both adaptable, but which is more? I'll have to go with me.
No.
You.
Doe, work with herself.
Why?
Hey, Jack. Don't worry about it. You batted 1,000, Jack.
Yes.
Sorry about that, Jack. You can square up with the bananas later. Jody, what will Richard say? Which one of you is more adaptable?
No, I am more adaptable than Richard. Definitely.
Huh? That's a definite. Yes. Here comes Richard now. Richard, between you and Dodie, which of you is more adaptable to change, would you say?
The only thing I'll change is my underwear. The answer is Jody.
That's it. You got it. Okay, here we go. Hold on, gang. This is for the game, Dorothy Jo. Between you and Bob, which of you is more adaptable?
Marker, definitely.
He is definitely more adaptable to change. Here he comes. Bob, this is for the game. I don't want you to feel any pressure, but if you miss this, Richard and Jody come storming from behind. Which of the two of you is more adaptable to change, you or Dorothy Jo?
There is absolutely no way I can miss this. I am more adaptable.
That's it. You got it. Dorothy Jo and Bob, Jody and Richard get it, split it in half. And there it is. Time is up. The Blues have won it. We shall return in just a moment and give the Blues their money. Ain't got.
Stay tuned for more of Game Show Saturday Night.
The big winners today, Dorothy Jo and Bob Barker with $450. We had $1,000. The blue section will divide $1,450. Congratulations to you. If you're around tomorrow, I would like you to tune in because of my wife and I, Ann. I remember her name. It's Ann. We're going to be right here on the panel, so tune in and see how we mess it all up. Won't you? Bert Covey saying so long. See you next time. Thank you, everybody.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.